we have a good time tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Wake up! Wake up out there. Y'all haven't had enough booze. Drink one. See, I'm having a good time. I gotta admit, I'm a little nervous. I've never done stand-up before, ever. I mean, I've told my story to my friends, and yeah, they laugh, but you know, with your friends, you never really know if they're laughing with you or at you. Yeah! So yeah, I signed up for this thing, and I found out that, yes, I am, in fact, the only girl. I'm the only girl with, they just paint the balls, to sign up for this thing. And my first thought was, wow, you know, that's kind of intimidating, you know? All these guys versus one chick. Now, I know some circles where that's just a formula for a really good night. But I'm no good at video games, so. So anyway, do we have any parents in the audience? Anybody? Come on. Parents? All right. Sunday was Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to all dads out there. Keep it up. I'm a single mom myself. Got two little boys, 3 and 2. They're the light of my life and the terror that I live in. Because, you know, parenting is tricky. You can go into any bookstore in the country and they've got a book on how to breed, raise, and care for any dog, cat, rabbit, anything on the planet. You pop out a kid, they don't hand you a manual. There's no little book that has the guidelines and caring instructions for that bad boy. No, no! And I'll be the first one to stand up here and admit that I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I haven't got the slightest fucking clue. I am making this shit up as I go and hoping they have money for therapy, because we're gonna need it. And I figured out that, you know, as a parent, you have two major obstacles. You have to be an authority figure in your kid's life, right? You have two major obstacles to this: mobility and communication. So when they're little, they learn to walk and they learn to talk, which means they learn to run away and scream, "No! Come back here, you little bastard." They run faster than I do. So when they're little, it's pretty easy. You know, you just pull a car from the discipline deck and, you know, spanking, time out, chain gang, whatever works. If you're lucky, if you do it right, you might have 8, 9 years of relative peace. Because they know that you are God. Your word is law, and by Christ, you can enforce that shit. Eventually, they're going to become teenagers. That's when you run into those two hurdles again: mobility and communication. At that point, they have access to cars, and either they stop talking to you altogether, or the only time they talk to you is to scream at you, "You're not being fair! I don't give a shit!" Yeah, but I want my kids to be well-adjusted, well-rounded, have a social life, and develop those necessary skills to succeed. So what am I going to do? I'm going to low-jack their car. But, you know, I'm not going to tell them about it. That ruins the surprise. So, you know, I told them to be home at midnight, 2 a.m., start rolling around, get on the internet, track them down, go to wherever they are, get a house coat, hot rollers, and some fuzzy boots. Gently remove my lovely, adorable children from their whatever they're doing. Take them home, sit them down, and explain to them their options. You can either do what I say and never, ever, ever have to endure your friends seeing Mom dressed up like a freak again, or we can go through this again. Mom can go out because Mom doesn't give a fuck. Mom's going to bring her whole life, the jerk she's. And then when we get home the next day, Mom's going to take all those naked baby butt pictures that Grandma took. Man, was she handy with a camera at that time. And she's going to poster size them, put your name on them, and post them up at school. How's that sound? So what are you going to do? Obey or not? And I don't believe in grounding, you know? You can't ground kids these days. Video games, computers, cell phones, that's like saying, "Hey, go to your room, have fun, play with all your friends. You can't see them, but you can still hang out." That's wrong. So while I don't believe in grounding, I do believe in public humiliation and psychological warfare. Thank you for your time. You guys have been great.
Dude, shut the fuck up.
She's
like obey or not. Stacy Willis, everybody. Give it up for her. Yeah.
I love starting with this now. I think that should be great.